see, you either love the Model X or hate it. And most people love them. They just can't afford it. They almost get the same status as a G-Wagon. They're unobtainable, really rare, and makes a big, huge statement. When I say unobtainable, I mean there's a long wait to get one of these. I mean, it takes a long time to get a Tesla in general, but especially the Model X. Listen, there's only two different trim levels, the basic and the plaid. To get a basic, you'll wait 1 year. To get a plaid, well, you'll have to go in hibernation for 2 years. Why'd my voice crack? Because I'm so amazed. This is a 2018 Tesla Model X 100D. The 100 stands for 100 kilowatt battery, and the D stands for dual motor. There's a motor in the front and a motor in the back pushing this Model X. Now this 18 is pretty much the same as today's Model X, except today's Model X is about $10,000 to $12,000 more. But the options are all the same. You can choose from the interior and exterior color, bigger wheels, full self-driving, and the seating arrangement. You can do a 5-seater, 6-seater, or 7-seater. Now let's check out why people love and hate the Tesla Model X. Now let's talk about why people love the Tesla Model X. For a solid 5,500-pound SUV, it gets 295 miles of range per charge. In 2023, the X will get 348 miles per charge. Now the Porsche Taycan Turbo is debatable at only 212 miles per charge. The Mercedes EQS only gets 350 miles per charge, and the highly anticipated Lucid Dream Edition, well, that gets 500 miles per charge, but that vehicle costs $170,000 with no options. That's 170. This is why people love the Tesla Model X. The Falcon door, just push that button and the Falcon door. And the Falcon door. It shuts completely. You have tons of headroom, like a spaceship, right? There's a pan roof here, so it gives me about 4 inches of head space. Now, people may not like the Tesla Model X because the window only rolls down about 7 inches. What about this 3 inches here? Because size matters, right? Aurelia, don't tell your mom and dad what I just said. Check this out. You come for the car door with the remote. Just push it twice. It opens up automatically. To shut it, you can pull the handle or you can just touch the brake and it shuts. To open it, opens automatically as well. Check that out. And then it closes by itself too. Just walk away with the key fob or card. And there you go. The interior has lots and lots of light with all that glass and white leather interior. It feels so roomy and vibrant inside. When you drive this, it will feel like no other car you've been in before. This Model X is a 6-seater with the captain's chairs, which is my favorite layout. It's an extra $6,500, but well worth it if you have kids and parents riding along with you. It gives everyone a lot more room. Has a lot of space in the second row than the 7-row layout. And the floors are flat because the chassis is a skateboard design. You'll have to get the 2021 model to get the yoke steering wheel and the LED screen in the second row like the Model S. Otherwise, you get a round steering wheel, two cup holders, and two vents in the back. To move the captain's chair forward, just push the button on the side and it automatically moves forward and tilts up. The back seats are perfect for small kids and small people, but uncomfortable for 6-footers like me. It's okay, doable, but not comfortable for long trips. The cargo space is pretty small, but you can push the third row seats down. There's a hidden button right here. Push it once for the headrest, push it twice to unlock the chair. Push down, same thing with the other side. Push the imaginary button right here. Push it again to unlock it. And there you go. Now you're not gonna have an even floor space, but it's enough to get that part or the supplies to your destination. You'll be disappointed to know that in order to put the chairs up, you have to go to the second row, push the imaginary button, and push the chairs up manually. For $100,000, it should go up automatically with a push of a button, like every SUV out there. I personally love the simplistic modern design and high-tech interior. You only get about 4 physical buttons. The remaining buttons are on the massive screen. It takes some getting used to. Don't let the haters tell you otherwise until you test it out for yourself. I absolutely love it, and I'm coming from a 2003 Lexus. This is how you know what trim level you're getting and what version of autopilot you have. Click on software, you'll see the trim level at the top, miles, then you'll see enhanced autopilot, which is a step above autopilot and one below self-driving. Click the information link and it will tell you what this version does. This one does everything except stop and go with signal lights and drive automatically with GPS. Here's a sample of what this X can do. You can open all the doors through this massive screen and close all of them too. If you pay for connectivity, you get all your social media and movie platforms. You can also play games while you're bored, but only in park.
Here are some of the games you'll find in Tesla. You'll recognize some of them, like Sonic Hedgehog, Backgammon, Asteroids, Breakout, Millipede, and this is Missile Command.
I'm not sure how this X got some of these games since my Y doesn't have most of them. You'll use the steering wheel or screen to play the game. Others, you'll need a joystick.
I want to give a quick shout out to my sponsors, Mercedes-Benz of downtown Los Angeles and Rafael Gonzales, for lending me their Tesla Model X for the day. If you're looking for a new used Mercedes-Benz or a luxury used vehicle, and they have lots of those, just check out their website. Just give Rafael a call, make an appointment, then come on down here and check it out. And by the way, please hit that like, subscribe, and notification button below. They love seeing those. And it really helps me get cars like the Tesla Model X and maybe that Jaguar F-Type to review for you. The first reason why people hate the Tesla Model X is because they can't grasp evolution and electric vehicles. And they have range anxiety. The penalty is that they're paying over $5.25 a gallon in California for premium unleaded in their Escalade, BMW X7, or their Porsche Cayenne. Number two, they're afraid of quality and refinement. Panels not matching, rippling paint, Falcon doors not opening. But the fact is that the X has been out since 2016, so Tesla's had 6 years to iron out everything, just like the Model S. And to see that review, just click that card above. What I think people love most about the Tesla is that Tesla sends you software updates at no charge, and this can possibly give you better performance, more games, different access to applications, and fun things like the Tesla light show. Just click the card above it. You can see one that I filmed on the Tesla Model S, but the X is better because the doors open up.
Since 2018, all Model X's come standard with adaptive air suspension. So the ride with these non-performance wheels and tires make the X's ride very comfortable. You still get performance modes and a quick 0 to 60 in just 4.7 seconds. The X is a full-size SUV and the interior is very huge. It drives like it's light on its toes because of its massive torque. There's a lot of visibility because of its huge windows and side view mirrors. You also get a frunk since this has no engine. One suggestion I have in getting a Tesla over other manufacturers is that Tesla has an exclusive huge charging network that only work with Teslas. United States has about 1,200 stations with over 14,000 superchargers. That's more than EVgo and ChargePoint combined. You'll typically see the 150 kilowatt charger, which will take about 40 minutes to fully charge a Tesla. And the latest and greatest are the 250 kilowatt chargers. And this will cut your time down to 25 to 30 minutes to fully charge your Tesla.
So there you go, the Tesla Model X 100D. I enjoyed making the video for you. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like, subscribe, and notification button below. I'm Randy. See ya!